Now that we're able to measure grass, we can start to process data to help us make decisions. This video will show you how to calculate average farm pasture cover and grass growth. In order to calculate average farm pasture cover, we need to measure the whole of the area on the same day. One way of doing this is to walk the whole area with a plate meter and process the data. As an example, I will show you how this is done on this block of land.
There are 5 fields in this block of land, and it's split into 9 cells or grazing areas. I will walk from field to field following the yellow path, measuring each cell as I go. For consistency, I'll be using the same route every time I measure.
The stock have left this field yesterday and left a residual of 1300. Today, the stock are in this field of red clover and hybrid ryegrass with a cover of 2500. The stock were here last week and there's a nice regrowth here and cover is up to 1600. Stock will be back in this field in a few days' time and there is now a cover of 2400 here.
There are a number of apps and software available to ease the process of collecting and processing the data, and spreadsheets such as this can be formulated to calculate the key data and produce a pasture wedge. But to explain how average farm cover and growth are calculated, we can look at these simple tables. Average farm cover is calculated by multiplying the cover with a hectare, then dividing the grand total with the total hectares. Growth for individual fields can be calculated by subtracting the previous measurements from the latest measurements and dividing with the number of days between measurements. Average growth in ungrazed fields last week was 45 kilograms trimatur a hectare.
In the next video, we'll be showing you how to calculate livestock grass demand.